Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guest, as General Secretary of the Represented Nations and People Organization, it is a great honor for me today to be here with you on the occasion of the 5th General Assembly of the Democratic Solidarity Party of Laos. First and foremost, on behalf of the UNPO, I would like to extend our congratulations to the party's new leadership recently elected in London. We would like also to express our gratitude to the former leadership of the DSPA. Since 1991, the UNPO has represented millions of oppressed, marginalized, and indigenous people worldwide, all united in their pursuit of defending and promoting their fundamental rights, and in particularly their right to self-determination. We would like to express our appreciation to the Democratic Solidarity Party of Alawas, member of the UNPO since 1998, for its commitment in promoting human rights and peacefully advocate for the rights of their people. I would like also to extend my support to the entire Awasi community, who persist in their willingness to celebrate their culture and language and fight for the preservation of their land despite of the ongoing oppression. We are extremely proud to have you as part of our organization, and all peoples and nations united within the UNPO membership fully support your unwavering struggle for freedom, justice, and self-determination. Iran is a nation of many nationalities, languages, and cultures. However, we are acutely aware that it has been governed for too long by an oppressive regime, predominantly led by Persian nationalists with the support of the Shia clergy. Successive regimes in Iran have intentionally kept Awazi Arabs, as well as other national and linguistic minorities, such as Kurds, Turks, Baloch, Lark, Turkmen, and many more, marginalized and excluded from a meaningful participation in the socio-political system. The current situation of the Awazi people is of our great concern. Despite of the fact that the land of the Awazi people accounts for 85% of Iran's wealth, the indigenous Awazi communities do not benefit of this richness. None of these resources are directed towards the well-being of the indigenous populations, who are forced to endure abject poverty and systemic discrimination. We deplore that the Awazi Arabs has been systematically stripped of the fundamental human rights by the Iranian government, who have relegated them to a second and third class citizens. Today, I would like to assure to all of you and to all Awazi people that you are not alone. All UNPO membership stands in solidarity with you all. Finally, I would like to voice my solidarity with the Woman Life and Freedom Movement led by women across the country of Iran. Me and all UNPO members, women and men without distinction, stand with all of you. Particularly, I would like to express my deep admiration for the women and girls, men and boys from minority communities who from inside and outside the country continue to fight for their rights, your rights, despite of being particularly targeted by national and transnational repression. Today, and with you all, I would like to applaud their and your courageous efforts. In closing, I want to extend my best wishes to the Democratic Solidarity Party of Alawas for a successful and productive General Assembly. I want to reassure you once again that our support for your cause remains unwavering, and I firmly believe that together we can work towards a brighter future for the Awazi Arab and for all unrepresented nations and peoples around the world. Thank you very much.